In this tutorial, we'll see how to randomize tile patterns in Godot inside the editor to spice up our environments without the hassle of placing tiles one by one. If you don't have a lot of time, or you're lazy, or both, you'll understand the struggle to create good random-looking tile patterns in your games. Going through the horrible process of putting tiles one by one got a bit too tedious for me, so I decided to find a way to do it procedurally. And as it turns out, it's pretty easy. We'll create the process from scratch and then see a few variations and additions we can make to better fit our needs. First, create a tile map with a tile set of 18 by 18. The tile should have different patterns. In my case, I'm using Kenny's pixel platformer blocks. If you want to use this tile set to follow along, these are the settings you need to use. The name of the tile set image is stonepack.png. Inside the tile set snap option, set the step to 18 by 18. The tile mode should be set to single tile. Select the single tiles you want to use and add collisions to them. Draw your level as you see fit with whichever tile. Add a script to the tile map. In this script, we'll write the logic to randomize tile patterns. We'll add tool at the beginning of the script to be able to randomize inside the editor instead of runtime. This will help with performance and allow us to tweak the randomized pattern as we see fit. We'll add two exported variables. Lock pattern will be a usability boolean to lock whichever pattern we're using to avoid randomizing when we have a pattern we like. Random int will be an integer to set a different random pattern. Setting it back to 0 will default to the first tile of the set. Link it to a setter function called tilemap randomization with random input as the parameter. Inside the tilemap randomization function, we return if lock pattern is true, avoiding randomizing again if the lock is set. We set the random input the setter receives to the random int exported variable. We then instance a new random number generator and randomize it. We add a check to see if the tool script is running inside the editor. We now iterate over each of the used cells and set the numeric index to be 0 as default. If the random input we are using is different than 0, we randomize the numeric index to any number between 0 and 24. These values are the possible indexes of the tile set. We then set the cell value to whatever numeric index we set in the previous steps. Now, back inside our level, we can use the random int to try out different patterns. Setting lock pattern will block any changes we make to random int, either by pressing the arrows or writing down numbers. Setting random int back to 0 will set the tile pattern back to its default. This technique is especially useful if you have very large levels, since it's a process that can get tedious very quickly, and the added benefit of being able to set it inside the editor is a big plus. However, if you wanted, you could also modify the code to be set on the ready function, and that way you have different patterns every time the scene is instanced. You could also add it on a timeout event and change it periodically. It might be a bit uncomfortable for players, but maybe you can find some use for it. In my own indie game, I used a slightly more complex system both for the tiles and the grass. The tiles have some more variations in size, meaning that I have to check if adjacent tiles exist. The grass just spawns if there are tiles underneath it, with some probability rules to not spawn tiles in every available position. So for your own games, go nuts. This simple randomization is a great starting point to add more and more complex systems for our tile sets. Please let me know what parts of the video you found useful in the comments and any tips you may have. And if you would like more videos like these, consider liking and subscribing, as it really helps.